story.
It's about what God coming into your life and doing things, but we believe it's took an awful long time. What he has and things have changed, it's not exaggerating the point that finding this place, finding Jackie, has actually saved my life. Going back a long time, when I was 3 I was taken into care. Father had left long before I was born. Well, before I was born anyway, but and I never actually knew my mom particularly. First few years in care, I think we're okay. Unfortunately, it's a story that I'm sure you're familiar with. While I was in care, I was abused by one of the care workers and a couple of his friends. I'll tell which relevant, one of his friends was a man of God, churchman. And it started off as just sort of routine abuse, but it ended up as full-on rape. Let's say I was 8. That carried on for a few years. Sort of things that happened, and this is relevant. When I was 10, I was promised a day out for my birthday, 10th birthday. I was really looking forward to this. It was a day in the country. What I didn't realise was that it was a day when all three of them were going to abuse me at the same time and take photographs and things. And I ended up in hospital. And that was when I decided to tell somebody what happened. Unfortunately, I was a 10-year-old in care. Was a priest, the two social workers, as you can believe, guess who they believed. And they sent me back into care to the same place. That carried on until I was 13 when I decided I couldn't actually take it anymore and made a few bad choices. I ran away, which may or may not have been a bad choice. I ran away to London, which was where I'd never been on the way to. I ended up in a part of London called King's Cross. And there were guys there that helped. They gave us a release. It was not an amazing number of people that were in the same situation. The release came in the form of a white powder. Cocaine. So by the time I was 13 and a half, I was hooked on cocaine, and he had to pay for that. And he had to pay for somewhere to live. And the only way to pay was prostitution. So there I was in London, between the ages of 13 and 16. I don't know what the name is, a red boy on the game. I was lucky at 16, I was arrested for soliciting. And that actually got me out of that particular spiral. It took 4 years to get off the cocaine and to be clean from it and all the other stuff that happened. I was lucky, I mean really that should have been the end of it, but it wasn't. I went to college, I went to art college, I got a degree. But the physical side, and you see there's been some stuff this week on the press notes, where you get concerned about the physical side of abuse, you know it's nothing. That's what happens. Not only have I lost 8 years, child growing up, I didn't have any self-respect. I didn't have self-esteem. I thought I was worthless. I'd been told during that time that I was so evil, even God didn't love me. That's why nobody answered the prayers. I used to pray that these guys wouldn't come around. And they did. The priest told me that that's why my father left, because I was so evil. My mother couldn't stand the sight of them, and I was worthless. And it stayed. Anyway, it was went through life trying to find something, trying to get some respect, promiscuous, all the things, booze, all sorts of stuff. Nothing worked, and I started to get very depressed, became quite ill, and ended up. I wanted to kill myself The last time was quite early on this year. I managed to obtain about 200 of topically, which I swallowed with several meters of vodka. And I didn't know. But just afterwards, I started talking to a lady. This is the good news now, because we met with family. She started talking about this place. I've never been in a church, literally since I was that big. I had very strong views in our churches, imagine. And in the end, she brought me here. And that's when the moment was about to happen. You guys are amazing. The first day we came, while you were speaking, and he was talking away, and all of a sudden, completely out of context, he started talking about abuse. And it was like somebody was pulling me in the chest. Actually, looked at Jackie and said, "What have you said?" And that's gone out. I was so shocked there to go out of somebody. Started to come, talk to Steve, people. But I've reached a point where Steve said, "I have to now let go before I give." What I know everybody here to do is I need help. Because right now I can't. I still hate those kids. What they did. Not only to me, but to other people as well as my kids involved. And I still got all this guilt because the questions that you ask yourselves, I don't know if you understand this, but I feel as though it was my fault. I did something in some way that made them think it was okay to do it. I know that I've talked to other people with abuse, maybe the ladies can understand it. It's the same thing, that there's that question of, did I do something? So I'm finding that a bit quite hard at the moment, which is pointless. But the other thing is to say, it's not bad news, it's good news, because I met Jackie, I met Chloe. So God sort of has started to lead me, brought me here. I'm from Manchester. I had to come to a place in Google and suddenly discovered that there is hope. There is a way out. And God does have a plan, and He's starting to reveal it to me now. And it's amazing. It's fantastic. Thanks for listening, but if you get time in your prayer, just to pray to help me take that last step in starting to forgive and everyone else.